Okay, this tutorial will talk about the Metroblast dev tag. So first I make a cube and I make a simple fracture here. Second, this I want to do, I make a ground and I go to the dev object here and I add and I take one piece here and a fracture so that I have dev break. Now I want to show you something. When you use dev break, you can see this. If you go here and you use that dynamic, so you can see this is more dark green. If I break again this, it's make more dark. If I break again, it's make more dark. Like this, you know how the level. So this is the level 1, this is level 2, and this is level 3. Okay, so let me can do this. Okay, next, you can go here in the view list and you can call dev. So like this, you can see all the dev pieces. In this case, it's only this here. So now if you hit play, okay, I need to put here also a static. So now if I hit play, you can see one species collision is break. Now let's explain a little bit how it works with the Metroblast here dev tag. The only I explain is this here, the dash, because this is exactly the same like here we explain in the next tutorial. So this I want to tell you is if you want, for example, you can see here now we have to play, you can see now the pieces is falling, great, nice. If you want to keep this, for example, to don't break these pieces, just to go back, it's just the original. This you can do is actually you can go here in the scale and make it, for example, a negative 100. Like this, you can see now the pieces is not breaking. So if I go back, you can see now the piece is breaking. So actually also you can animate this, for example, you can go here and you can see how it's working. Okay, the next is I want to tell you is about the dash now. If I have enabled the dash here, we explain a little later how it's working the dash. So I go here and I create a very fast here dash name, create, enable the dash, and now with the dash I go here and I save my shape, something like this. And now if I play, I need to click review. Okay, so if I read it now, you can see the dash how it looks like. Also, you notice here is create also another dash here, the one is breaking. Here you can change, of course, the size if you want, the radius. So here you can make it smaller, bigger, anything you would like, and it looks like good in your progress, in your project, I mean. So this I want to explain now is, if this piece I don't want to make a dash, you can go here in the dash, you can click skip. So if I do this now and I hit play, you can see this is create dash again because I need to click update. So when I click update and now I do again, you can see this piece is not make any dash. And this I want to show you. So let's go here and there is another option, skip all. So this is me, it's not make for the original object dash, any dash. And here you see nothing happened because we have skip. So now I can enable this and I can click update, and now you can see actually I have dash only the dev break pieces. And here because it's created a lot dash, you can change this. If you go change and you change the pieces and click update. Okay, so when I hit play, you can see now I have less dash. And the other thing is the size, is about the size of the pieces, how is bigger. So here you can control, and here is between when it's going forward to the other pieces. It's created dash. So here you can control this is a value here. It's exactly the same like here in the size. How it's working. And this I want to explain a little later in the next tutorial. So basically this I want to show you how it's working the dev tag.